Hey, what's up? Welcome to NAM Design. In today's video, I will showcase 7 amazing Figma plugins that I personally use for my projects, and you might want to add them to your workflow. Here is part 3, so let's get started. Number 1. Mockup Plugins. This plugin allows you to showcase your designs using a library of mockups, ranging from devices to print materials, all within Figma. Let me show you how it works. First, run the plugin, and you will see a variety of mockups available. Next, navigate to the menu to explore all the mockup categories, such as branding mockups, device mockups, distortion, and more. For example, if you want to use iPhone mockups, select device mockups, then proceed to select the style you prefer. You have options like isolate, environment, clay, long scroll, and more. For this example, let's pick the environment style. After that, click the plus icon to add your design by selecting your frame. Once you're finished, click paste, and your mockup will be ready. It's incredibly helpful. Number 2, Icons8. With this plugin, you can access over 1.5 million icons, photos, and illustrations without ever needing to leave Figma. Simply run the plugin and choose the graphic you need. As you can see, there are a lot of icons, illustrations, and photos available for your project. Let's say you need an illustration. You would go to the appropriate tab and select the illustration you want, which you can filter by style or category. Once you are satisfied with your selection, just click on the illustration, and it will appear right on your canvas. It's really helpful. Number 3, HTML.to.design. Whenever I need design ideas from real websites, I always use this plugin to explore their structure. This plugin can convert any HTML design into fully editable Figma designs. Using the plugin is simple, just run it and enter the URL of the website you want to import into Figma. You can then choose the viewport to import desktop, mobile, or tablet. Once all set, click the import button. As you can see, the website is now fully editable. It's really helpful. Number 4, Contrast. Contrast allows you to quickly generate a AAA or AA type contrast report for all text across your artboards at once. Simply select a few layers and run the command to view your report. In the example shown, there is a red color indicating that the color contrast has failed. Now, let's highlight the text and change its color. After that, we will generate the report again to check if the contrast is acceptable. And voila! The text has changed to green, which means the contrast is good. It's incredibly helpful. Number 5, Faker Plugins. This plugin is designed to enhance your workflow by quickly generating realistic content such as names, addresses, descriptions, and more, saving you time when creating mockups. To use the plugin, simply select the placeholder text you want to change. For example, if you want to replace a name, run the plugin, select the placeholder text, and replace it as you like. It's that easy. Number 6. Typography Style Guide. Whenever I want to keep the fonts I use organized and visually harmonious across a project, I rely on this plugin. Because it allows me to create a typography style guide automatically using my local text styles. To do this, you simply need to run the plugin, and a new page will be created. As you can see here, we now have a well-organized typography style guide. It's that simple. Number 7, Color Style Guide. With this plugin, you can generate a comprehensive color style guide with just one click using your local color style. Let me show you how to do it. First, set your local style. Mine is shown here. After that, run the plugin and a new page will be created. As you can see, here is the color style guide I use for this project. It's super helpful. That's a wrap for today's video, folks. Make sure to stay tuned for more exciting content. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you in the next video. Bye.